Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Last time on JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, we had Let's Go Hunting. Oh crap, it does have an exclamation point. I'm going to have to go fix that now. Yes, Let's Go Hunting, where Jotaro and Josuke went hunting for two rats that had stands. And that's exactly what they did. And it was a good, I don't want to say coming of age moment for Josuke, but a good coming into his own moment, I suppose, where he basically had to take the shot against the rat while Jotaro distracted, and it worked, and it was all nice and good. So yeah, you may be able to hear that my voice is a little hoarse. It's the end of the day. And not just the end of the day, I mean, like, I've been recording a lot today, because I'm doing a bit more on Mondays now. And that's probably how it's going to be for a little while with JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. So, hope you're prepared for a few weeks of low-energy JoJo reactions. Which, hey, maybe that means I won't be ranting so much about JoJo, but we'll have to see. With that said, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure, so let's go ahead and just get right into this episode of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Here we go. You know, I was so afraid when it was going to be like, oh, it's a Koichi and Rohan episode. I was so fucking scared. I was like, this is gonna blow. But no. Plot. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we found a plot. I think we found the plot of part four. Finally. After all these weeks, we finally found the plot of part four. Okay. That was a lot. So, that was quite a lot, actually. I mean, yeah, that was interesting, to say the least. So, we have ghosts and a serial killer, and that's what we've been seeing since the beginning, haven't we? Because at the beginning, the very beginning of part four, like, the first thing we see is a severed hand. And we saw that after we defeated Otoishi, where it cut to, you know, someone, and then, you know, you see the hand on the bathtub, and then you see someone come in and pick up that severed hand. Oh my god, guys, we found the plot. We finally found the plot of part four! It took 17 episodes, but we found the plot of part four. Kira. And he's... and he's a killer. Oh my god. Just the... Sorry, the way I said that too. And he's a killer. I don't know why I just thought of... what the hell? I guess Killer Queen... by Queen. So, which I think, I'm pretty sure that's a reference at some point. I don't know where, but that is one thing. Yeah, I don't really know where it pops up, but like, you hear stuff like, because I also see, like, I basically see, like, references. Not, like, anything specifically plot-related, but I know there's, like... I think there's a stand in part 5 or something. There's a reference to the Notorious B.I.G. And that's mainly because I have to, like, you know, schedule out, like, all the episodes and stuff. So, yeah. I don't know. But, yeah. And he's a killer. She's a killer. Queen. I could try singing that song, but I don't know it off the top of my head. Well, hang on. She's a killer queen. Gunpowder gelatine. Dynamite with a laser beam. Guaranteed to blow your mind. That was a bit off key. Anyway. Plot! Boy, that was a lot. That was a lot. You know? And it's hilarious, too, that it's like, oh, hey, a girl. When was the last time we had a girl on JoJo? You know, like, I mean, yeah, we had Yukiko. But I'm talking like a JoJo girl, you know? The last JoJo girl... I mean, I guess Tomoko kind of counts, but... The last JoJo girl was Suzy Q, you know? Because Jonathan had Irina, Joseph had Suzy Q, and then Jotaro, there was nothing in part three, you know? Like, there was the little girl, but that... She wasn't gonna be, you know, the JoJo girl. Jotaro never got a JoJo girl. And Yukiko was not going to be a JoJo girl. And then finally, it's like, oh, hey, maybe, who knows, maybe this will be our JoJo girl of part four. Nope. She's dead. She is already dead. Reimi Sugimoto. Okay, so... First off, Rohan is back. Good use of Rohan, at least. For a character who was ungodly annoying in his own arc, this wasn't too bad, honestly. And yeah, I did see before this episode that this was called Rohan Kishibe's Adventure. That honestly scared me, because I was like, oh god, this is gonna be a Rohan episode. It's not gonna be a good episode. And then when it was Koichi, I was like, oh, this is gonna suck. But it wasn't about that. It's very weird involvement of Rohan, I will say. It's like, you know, he has the big reveal of like, oh, he was like friends, basically. He was friends, basically, with Raimi. But it's like weird character development for Rohan that I wasn't expecting, you know? Maybe it's because we don't really get character development for former villains. They don't really come back, you know? But it was interesting. I liked it. So, yeah. I like how he's improving Heaven's Door as well. So, it must have been a month since that episode. Because that's what they've said, you know? That's what they said, is that at least the manga would be on hiatus for a month. So, So yeah, but he finally healed up after two episodes, and he's also improved Heaven's Door, which that was actually really cool. I like that. So he can launch his artwork basically through Heaven's Door, and then use that to write in someone, which is very interesting. So that was really cool. I actually do like that. It honestly does make Heaven's Door a bit more useful, you know. Because that's the thing, you know, when you get, like... And that episode with Rohan is a perfect example of why you hope that you will never get a horrible stand. Because Hazamata has a terrible stand, you know? Like, that is something he cannot just use. But Heaven's Door, while not being, you know, strength like Star Platinum or even Shining Diamond... it is very useful. Like, you can get very creative with how you use that, you know? So that was good. I like how Heaven's Door has been improved. And yes, so now we have met Reimi Sugimoto. And honestly, yeah, it's like, she is really, really cute, but then she's dead. I like that moment where they were talking, they were doing fortune telling versus profiling, which was very interesting. So yeah, so she's more of a Pocky fortune teller, I guess, and she did honestly figure him out, but then I like that he immediately, you know, he can see all this stuff about her and, you know, infer things about her, because that's what he does. He has to understand a lot of different types of people because he's a manga artist, so that was really, really good. I like that moment. So, Reimi Sugimoto is a ghost. I mean, I guess if we've had vampires, it makes sense that ghosts also exist. We've had vampires and zombies. The next thing is ghosts and witches, basically. It'd be interesting, but hey, maybe we're going to get a witch at some point in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. But yeah. Although I could see just a witch being just someone with a stand, you know? But a ghost, no, a ghost is completely separate, which is interesting. Which, I mean, we've basically had three magic systems up until now. One being Hamon, the second being vampirism, and the third being Stans. So it's not unlikely to introduce some new sort of fantastical thing, but that is very interesting that, yeah, it has nothing to do with Stans. I do really like that. It has nothing to do with Stans. It's just, no, they are ghosts, and they, in every sense of the word, they are ghosts. Now, it's interesting because, as I've been watching and reading Sailor Moon, actually, they will occasionally just bring up ghosts, and it's like, oh, these exist. But I've started to realize that this seems to be just more within Japanese culture, where it's like, yeah, here's a ghost or a yokai, and because that's the thing in Sailor Moon. In Sailor Moon, all the enemies are, you know, all the monsters are brought forth by the main villains. But occasionally, there will just be a ghost that pops up with no explanation of where it came from. It just is a ghost. And it starts doing all this stuff that a normal, you know, villain monster would do. So it's not too far off that this would be the case in JoJo. That, yeah, there are ghosts within JoJo's, the world of JoJo as well. And it seems like the reason that Rohan and Koichi are able to see Raimi where most people can't is because they have Stans. Which is very interesting. That's a very interesting use of that. Which, I mean, you know, we've always had this thing since the beginning of Stardust Crusaders that, you know, a stand is basically a psychic projection from the person. It's a psychic ability, and ghosts kind of, you know, fall into that sort of category of a psychic thing, you know? So I like that, yeah, because, and it is sort of like, honestly, a stand is almost like their spirit, basically, you know? It's the embodiment of a person's spirit, you know? So it makes sense that stand users could see literal spirits, you know? It's almost like, it's basically like stand users can create a ghost, and then they can see people who have become ghosts themselves. That is honestly pretty interesting. Now, it makes you wonder, you know, would someone, you know, would a vampire be able to see this? Would someone with Hamon be able to see this? You know, if we brought in Kars and Caesar, would they be able to see a ghost? By the logic of Stans, I suppose not, you know? I suppose not, but it would be very interesting, you know? It would be interesting if, because they also have this sort of, you know, almost otherworldly power, that they would also be able to see ghosts. But, as it stands, stand users being able to see and interact with ghosts, that works. I do really like that. And yeah, there's a serial killer on the loose. That is crazy. And that, I mean, that's plot right there. Honestly, considering we've seen that like a couple times now, that has to be plot, you know? And there's no way this guy doesn't have a stand, this Kira dude. So that's gotta be it. This guy's gotta have a stand. So he's a serial killer that just showed up, and he licked her hand too. So here's the thing, this guy knew that she put her hand under her bed and her dog would let out a whimper and then lick her hand. He knew that and imitated it to where she thought that was her dog Arnold. That's creepy. Because see, at first I was thinking maybe it was Angelo, because Angelo was kind of like that too, you know? He would go and, you know, rape kids and everything. Now, it seems like he didn't rape her like Angelo. It's just that he killed her. And it does make you wonder, it makes you wonder if he cut off her hand, but she did have both of them, and they both still have, her and Arnold still have the wounds from how they died. So I would guess that that's not the case. But yeah. But there's just a serial killer on the loose, which is crazy. And yeah, Rohan was there too, and she saved him, apparently. which is interesting. Again, interesting character development for Rohan, I must say. I also like the distinction, kind of going back a little bit, that Heaven's Door can only read the living memories of a person. So that's why, you know, he can affect her as a ghost, but everything from the past 15 years of her being a ghost, he can't see, which is interesting. So yeah, that's just a very interesting... And so she has been waiting for someone to listen and will hope, you know, she is in doing this in the hopes that someone will find him and stop him, you know? He's like this curse on Moria. And he's been operating for at least 15 years. Like, this guy has been sort of a curse on Moria, which is interesting. And it makes you wonder, though, has he had his stand the whole time, you know? If he has a stand, I guess that's the other question, if he has a stand, you know? Maybe not. Maybe he hasn't had a stand this whole time. I don't know. But yeah, so, and it's also interesting, you know, they say at the end, you know, if we tell this to Jotaro and Mr. Joestar, they're going to ask if he has a stand. And if he doesn't have a stand, it's not their business. And that... To their credit, yeah, that is kind of true. But at the same time, it's like, dude, even if he's not a stand user, I feel like that's all the more reason to stop him because he can't fight back, you know? You could go and end his reign of terror so quickly, you know? But, yeah, it's true. If he's not a stand user, it's not really their, I guess, jurisdiction, basically, you know? So that's pretty interesting. Now, considering, again, we had that scene at the end, and then we've had the teases throughout all of Part 4, it does make me think, okay, this guy has to be a stand user, you know? He has to be a stand user, and he has to, you know, be sort of our, I guess, our main villain. And I guess if this is our main villain, then this is... I mean, this is our first non-vampiric villain, you know? Because Dio, both times, was a vampire, and Kars was, you know, the ultimate life form based on the Pillarmen and vampires, you know? So this will be our first non-vampiric villain. And he's just a fucking serial killer, which is crazy. We also had the whole thing of Don't Look Back, which was interesting. Now, this does remind me of Merlin, where... there was an episode, it was after, spoilers, after the death of Uther Pendragon, where Arthur went and talked to him in the spirit world, and he tricked Arthur into looking back, which basically released his spirit. And the same thing basically applied here, where, yeah, you don't want to look back, because otherwise, basically hell itself will, you know, latch on and keep you, basically. So, that was very interesting, and I like the resolution of that Rohan uses Heaven's Door to eliminate Koichi's ability of sight. So, again, another use of Heaven's Door. I do actually like that. I do really like that, how he's using Heaven's Door. So, that's really good. Just a very interesting episode. An interesting episode altogether. And again, for an episode, I thought I was going to hate this episode because it was Rohan and Koichi, and I'm sick and tired of Koichi episodes, and I really did not like Rohan. But all things said and done, that was a pretty decent episode, and because it's plot! Guys, we found the plot! I'm starting to sound like Koichi a little bit. Reverb! Kind of almost sounds like Shaggy when I do it like that. But yeah, we found the plot. Whoever this Kira guy is, this fucking crazy serial killer who just severs women's hands. Like, Christ, it's terrifying, you know? I do love, though, he's a villain who killed a dog. Like, God dang it. You know, with every passing day, we stray from the light of Kars, you know? Kars didn't kill the dog. Dio killed the dog. And now this Kira guy killed the dog. Ugh. But yeah, very interesting. Very interesting. I'm very curious to see where we're going from here. Because, yeah, after the past, you know, 5 episodes or so, Well, we've had some good ones. We've had some good episodes, like, you know, Let's Go Hunting. That was really good. We picked up Something Crazy, the Chili Pepper episodes. But the manga, the Rohan episodes, while, yes, ending well with, it did end well with, you know, Josuke beating him down, and then we got the whole origin story of Josuke's hair and stuff. That was good. But the rest of that was just insufferable, basically. But now, seems like we're gonna get into some really good JoJo stuff. So, I'm excited. I'm really excited to see where we're going. And yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. So, I don't know if we're gonna go straight into it next episode, or are we gonna maybe finagle, you know, mingle a little bit more before we get around to it. But this seems to be plot, and I am all for it. So yeah, with all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. There's a bunch of links on screen if you want to go click around to any of those. There's a playlist for all of my JoJo's Bizarre Adventure reactions, as well as another video you can go click on if you want. There's also a subscribe button and a Patreon button on screen, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys later.